Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Dr. Arnav, sir. Next. Yeah. First, I'll talk about the anatomy of the cornea. You know that the eye is shaped like a globe. It consists of three layers, outer, middle, and inner. The cornea forms anterior 1/6 of the outer layer. The rest is formed by the sclera. And you all know that it's a transparent layer. And because the collagen lamella is parallelly arranged. And it's a hyperbolic in shape. Centrally spherical and peripherally it is flatter. Central thickness, this is the average thickness, is 550 millimicrons. Peripherally it is 600 millimicrons. And it has five layers: epithelium, Bowman's membrane, stroma, which constitute 90% of the total thickness, Descemet's membrane, and endothelium. Yeah. And this topic is mainly for the people who are there, who are here, for their children and younger children. And this LASIK laser is meant for younger individuals. See, when I was doing ophthalmology, I've been practicing ophthalmology for the past 25 years. 1985, but 2003, I started doing this procedure. Before that, only two centers were doing this procedure. And even conference, so I'm very proud to show it to the non-ophthalmologists. You have other alternatives like glasses, contacts. So do you wish to have clear vision without glasses or contact lenses? The answer is yes. Yeah. What is LASIK? First, what is laser? Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation, LASER. What is LASIK? Laser in situ keratomelusis. Previously, this laser was done for myopia. They will scrape the epithelium, then do the laser, and then they'll put an extended wear contact lenses, that's like bandage contact lenses. Instead of putting bandage covering the eye, they put a contact lens. After 2-3 days or a week later, they'll remove the contacts. By that time, the epithelium will heal. But that first 3 to 7 days, the person will have severe watering, redness, irritation. So the next come this LASIK. Here we take a flap and then do the laser. So when LASIK or whatever the laser is advised, it is done after a thorough screening using latest equipment at a good center under the care of expert hands. Next. The object of LASIK is you will not be dependent on glasses. You know, people with -3, -4, or -5, as soon as they get up in the morning, they'll have to wear the glasses. Without that, they cannot manage their day-to-day routine. So, next. So this equipment is called Zioptics 100, one of the latest equipment. And now, see, the ideal age is after 18 years. And once the myopia gets stabilized, at least for a period of 1 year. And before we do the LASIK laser, we do a op scan. I'll just show the instrument, otherwise it will take a longer time. See, our laser vision center is situated at Annanagar, next to Saravana Bhavan Hotel, about 10 buildings after Saravana Bhavan Hotel. And this equipment is from Bausch & Lomb. The OPSCAN gives a complete picture about the eye, about the cornea, the shape of the cornea, the thickness of the cornea, the anterior corneal curvature, posterior corneal curvature, and it rules out keratoconus also. Keratoconus is the main contraindication for LASIK, for laser. And this is the equipment to do the OPSCAN. So suppose if I send about 10 patients for OPSCAN, I'll be able to do only for 7 or 8 patients. The remaining will be rejected because of the less corneal thickness and other factors. Next. And this is how the picture you get it with the OPSCAN. Go to the LASIK. You are the LASIK. Now we have two types. One is you do the now the eye is opened with your speculum. 4% xylocaine or now the propranolol is instilled to anesthetize, and these are the markers I do on the lateral aspect and the lower aspect. And this procedure is done with a microkeratome. This is the microkeratome which has a suction inbuilt in that. With the help of the foot pedal, when the foot pedal is pressed, the suction is built up and the cornea becomes flat. And this is the microkeratome which has gone through that and come back. And a flap is created. This is not a full thickness flap. This procedure is done through a microkeratome. I'll just show that. Then another procedure, even the flap is taken through the laser, with the help of the laser, with the help of a femtosecond laser. That's called the interlace. Here, the flap thickness is roughly about 140 microns. In femtosecond, you can get even 90 micron thickness. Why certain people are rejected? Because after the procedure, the bed should be around 275 microns without the flap. See here, so So this is the flower which is created with the help of the microkeratome. See, initially I take the corneal thickness with the help of the pachymeter, and now here I'll do the thickness of the cornea. So the difference will be the thickness of the flap. Here you can take the minimal thickness, 140 microns. But this will not be exactly 140, it may be 120 or 130. This usually cuts at the level of the stroma. And before that, the laser machine is set with the patient's details, the power, everything. But the machine will decide how much of laser to be applied. And here the laser has been applied, that's why you said you saw the opaque area. Flap is put back. It hardly takes a minute to for the flap to get stuck. The same procedure will be repeated in the other eye. Here, so no blade, no keratome is used. This is with the help of femtosecond laser. This is a separate equipment which will be in the same room. So the patient lying down, same procedure. This for under patient. So the eye is opened with a speculum. Eye is anesthetized with the help of 4% xylocaine. We have separate disposable equipments for this, so which is fit on the eyeball.